Solana Beach is sometimes referred to as Solana Wall. The name comes from the privately built seawalls aimed at protecting ocean bluff homes in this tiny sliver of a city just west of I-5. The 30 to 40 foot walls are a scourge to environmentalists and some beachgoers. And now the city wants to put a time limit on the walls. Los Angeles Times San Diego Bureau Chief Tony Perry has reported on the issue. He's with me now. Tony, we actually have some photographs of those walls. We have them here with us. Tell us what we're looking at.
Well, there it is. There's Solana Beach, or Solana Wall, as the environmentalists would have it. Walls 30 to 40 feet tall, concrete, anchored into the bluff. But here we go. That's a little further down the beach, and you can see the tide coming in. That's a bit at low tide. At high tide, the water comes all the way to the wall.
They're designed to look natural, but do they?
A little bit, depending on what angle you have. And there it is. There's one of the walls and a sign telling you, watch out for those crumbling bluffs. The bluff is particularly crumbly in Solana Beach, and it crumbles down, and it is stopped by the wall, which folks will tell you that keeps it from going to the beach and smoothing the beach out.
Now, this last picture is very dramatic. How many houses have walls like this, and how many are that close to the edge?
Well, the bluff is, what, 2 miles long. The beach is 2 miles long, lots of different walls. This is more dramatic than most, but all of the walls are meant to keep Mother Nature from eroding that property and imperiling either the condo projects or the single-family homes. So that's more dramatic, but only by degree.
So tell us about Solana Beach's proposed plan to deal with seawalls. What's the big change and why now?
Well, the California Coastal Commission, that's the big change. The city of Solana Beach is the last city to get a local coastal plan. And you've got to have one of those if you want to reclaim your coastal planning capability, authority. And because Solana Beach is all on the coast, virtually, it really hasn't had the authority that other cities have to decide its future. To satisfy the Coastal Commission, it has passed a plan, lots of details, but one of the plan's most controversial details would put a 20-year limit on wall permits. Everything grandfathered in if you have a permit now. Need a new permit for a new wall? Want to improve your wall, shore it up, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera? 20 years from the date you get it. Now, that's not going to help your resale value. In fact, it's probably going to hurt your resale value.
And property owners are not happy
with it.
They filed lawsuits.
In court we go.
What are their arguments?
Well, their arguments are this 20-year limit, that's a taking of property without compensation. Similar suit was filed in Solana Beach, and there a Superior Court judge said, you know, you're right. Putting a 20-year limit and saying you have to tear down your wall in 20 years, that's taking your property without compensation, struck it down. Now the same issue in Solana Beach, not precedent setting, but the same style of issues are now in Solana Beach with its 2 miles of beachfront and its crumbling bluffs and its angry homeowners and its very, very determined environmentalists.
And those environmentalists, they are not happy with the walls. What have the walls done to the beaches?
Again, the geologists would tell you, at least the geologists who are on the environmental side would say, what they do is they stop the replenishment of sand from the bluff down to the beach. The bluff crumbles naturally through waves at the bottom, but at the top it crumbles because of wind and winter rains. Now, when that occurs, Mother Nature would have had that sand from the bluff come tumbling down onto the beach, providing additional sand on the beach. But with a wall, it blocks that sand from getting to the beach, and then the beach flattens out, and the beach then shrinks, I am told, because of an energy transfer that the waves come all the way to the bluff wall, but they can't bring in enough sand. Skinny beach. At high tide, that water comes all the way to the walls. Now, on the other side, they say, no, that's not what happened. The reason we don't get much sand on those beaches is because of the grids that have been built in Oceanside and Camp Pendleton.
Where does the California Coastal Commission come down on this? I know that you said that the permit limit was part
of... They want a plan, and until they approve your plan, you lose your authority over planning in the coastal zone. All of this city is in the coastal zone. Final city to get a coastal plan. They like the 20-year idea, but the homeowners don't, we're going to go to court and see if it stands.
Any room for a compromise?
You would think. Council is meeting next week, going to throw some language into their coastal plan that seems to protect homeowners. I don't think it's going to be enough. I think the laws of man and the laws of nature are going to court.
Tony Perry, thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure.